But no, barbarians are good for tanking. They hit pretty hard. Demon Hunter looks like that's what everybody says. Everybody loves Demon Hunter. I cannot get behind it. I did not enjoy it that much. I can see how people would enjoy it, but I cannot. It was so boring for me to play. Maybe it's because I'm just like used to like tanking. But I don't know. It was fun. Demon Hunter was a fun playthrough. The only character that I really did not enjoy was the monk. I really did not enjoy the monk at all. And unfortunately, the one class that I did not enjoy, I'm gonna have to go re-fucking play. It's gonna be fucking awesome. Highest DPS class, my barbarian. Or the overall is, I'd probably say a wizard. But my highest DPS class is my barbarian. No, I don't feel like the Demon Hunter is the highest DPS class. It might be, I'd have to actually do some research on it, but I don't think it is. The monk's probably the fucking lowest. God damn, I fucking hate the monk. I really don't want to replay that goddamn character, but I'm gonna have to. Because I really want to max this game out. And what are the last three achievements I need? It's reach level 70 in hardcore, which I'm gonna do before I even beat the game. Kill Diablo in hardcore and kill Malthael in hardcore. That's literally gonna be, those are the last three fucking achievements I need besides the fucking levels, get all my fucking characters level 70, which I don't want to do again. I'm probably just gonna play a barbarian when I do my hardcore, and then get to level 70, and then just run through the game. Cause at level 70 on hardcore, you'll do pretty good. Any downsides to barb? Honestly, in my opinion, no. It's skills are pretty great. There's one skill called the Call of the Ancients, I think it is. And it's literally OP as fuck. Like, those four ancients will literally just run through everything. Loves research. But I love the barbarian. It's easily one of my favorite characters to play on. The only reason I'm not still grinding is just because I want to raise up all my other classes. So if I play with people and they need a Demon Hunter, I can play a Demon Hunter. If they need a Monk, I can be a Monk. If they need a Barbarian, I can be a Barbarian. Obviously, my Barbarian is going to be my strongest, but I'll have all these characters up to at least Torment 3, I'd say. What skills, etc. am I using? I don't know what my Barbarian uses. I'm playing on a Crusader. The Crusader, I would say, isn't the best by any means. It's kind of weak. I mean, you can wield. What's the one I'm using? It's this one. You can wield a two-handed weapon in your main hand while bearing a shield in your offhand. That one's cool. Yeah, I think that's probably the best one. But it reduces your DP, your damage by 20%. Jason Eugene Bond. That was one of the funniest things I ever saw in my life. Actually, I think Vondahar is I think it's E, but other than that, I think you got it right. Okay, stop fucking teleporting me around, you fucking rat. I'm sick and tired of being fucking teleported. Come on, ball. Make your peace quickly.
Go.
Can't even spell the word spelling. Isn't that ironic? Okay, fuck off. Right side. 80%, then we'll go face the Rift Guardian. I could probably do two more rifts and then I'll have to get off for the day. Burn in the light. Did I show you my barb? Not today. I don't have time to today. Unfortunately, it's going to be close just to finish up what I want to finish up today. I might not even make it completely on time. I might be a little bit late to end the stream, but it'll be fine. I'm just trying to run through these games and get the fucking keystones that I need. Not even gonna hit 155 today. But I got 6 fucking Paragon levels, so that's okay, I guess, for what I've been doing. Alright, man. Yeah, I'll be streaming tomorrow for sure. It'll probably be more Diablo because there's a lot I need to do now. Now that I'm actually getting back into this game. And tomorrow I won't have to end the stream at fucking 2 in the afternoon. I'll be able to stream till like 5 or 6. Best way to get good, decent gear while playing the story, just play. You'll get gear as you go, and then after you're done with the game, just go do Nephilim Rifts or Adventure Mode. Both are good ways. I'd say do Nephilim Rifts to get to 70 and then do... Actually, just keep doing Nephilim Rifts. They seem to be the best way to get gear. I mean, I went up from this to this today. And I can play on this difficulty, but it takes me a little bit longer. So I went up from Expert to Torment in like 4 hours, not even. Which is a pretty good jump. But yeah, just playing the game will give you a good decent bit of gear. It'll give you good enough gear to beat the game. There's not really any grinding needed.
The Rift Guardian has arrived.
All I can tell you is I'm not excited to replay my fucking monk. Or to replay a monk.
Patience.
This guy's annoying. Off, asshole.
I am returning to town.
Why do I have 3 notifications on Facebook? Fuck off. God damn. I don't give a fuck about 2 of these. We fuck right off.
You have.
I might hit 155 today. Yeah, that would bug the shit out of me, boy, to be honest. Make sure all my gear is the best. Eh. Ooh, those are good. Not enough that I'd want to keep them and get rid of my 4,000 life per second.
Embrace you.
It will probably be out. Yeah, I should have time enough to do one more rift after this. I should have plenty of time for at least that. And tomorrow I'll probably actually I might start on my witch doctor tomorrow. But I'm not sure. I might just stay on my crusader, grind up some more gear. Maybe play my barbarian, just grind up my paragon. Try and get to like 200 tomorrow. Instead of doing the story on a second character, what else can I do? Honestly, I don't know. I beat the story. The story was the first thing I did on every one of my characters. So I'm not sure. I think you can do adventure mode right away. Nephilim rifts are kind of like out of the question because you start on hard difficulty right away. I mean, you could do them. If you can do one, you'll be set. Because you're not going to get any legendary gear really at level one, obviously, so. But I'm not sure. I beat all the story the first time on all of my characters. That was what I did that before I did anything else. Fuck off! I'd rather a fucking conduit pylon right there, to be honest. Wait, there's a legendary. Yeah, there he is. What's up, butthole? It's what I'm doing right now. You kill a percentage of enemies, and then a Rift Guardian will spawn, and then you kill him and get gear. But in my opinion, it's the fastest way to level up once you're at level 70, or even like after you beat the story. Just don't play. Like the basic rifts is what I'm doing right now to get keys, and then you'll level up pretty fast. I think it took me like 5 hours to get from 35 to 70, which is pretty good. It might not even have taken that long. But just the basic rifts, should you pick up every item? I do for the most part. And even no matter what, the gear you get, if you don't use it, you can always salvage it for parts and shit where you can make gear, which is what you can make gear out of. That's what I'll do. That's what I do every time I finish up a rift. I'll salvage all my gear that I'm not going to put on and then go to the next rift. But yeah, I think I might just honestly get my fucking paragon to 200 tomorrow. And then, why the fuck does my phone screen keep turning up? Fuck off! Because I know I have a bunch of keys on that account. Or on that character. And then, I can transfer these keys over. I can throw them in my chest. Need about I'd probably need 60 keys all together to get to 200 even on my barbarian, which I'm playing on torment like fucking 5. God, this fucking boss is so annoying. Fuck off. That fucking guy was annoying as shit. Holy fuck. But yeah, I'll probably, and then once I hit 200, I think the next stream I do, which would probably be, because I think tomorrow I'll probably play this and grind up my Paragon. Thursday, I'll play some Killer Instinct, get some achievements on there. And then Friday, I'll probably, Friday and Saturday morning, I'll probably start and finish my second Monk playthrough, which I really don't want to fucking do, but, you know, achievements. And it's not my fucking monk. I don't even know. It'd probably be my demon hunter, because I know my wizard worked. Actually, no, it has to be my monk, because my demon hunter and my wizard both worked. My monk was the only one that glitched. It'd probably, it'd either be my monk or my wizard, but I'm fairly certain my wizard worked, registered. And I'm fairly certain my demon hunter worked and registered. I love those ones that just sit there and let you just fucking just beat the shit out of them. They don't move. So great. But yeah, this one, the rifts are the best for XP because there's so many fucking enemies. Like, I'll probably kill 600 or so enemies, I'd say, every single rift. Which is a good bit of XP. It's a good bit of XP when you're not level 155 Paragon. Which Paragon, when you get there, you get these points every single Paragon level, which you can upgrade your shit, and those transfer between characters. So if you wanna, like what I did with my second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth playthroughs, I got my Barbarian, I used my Barbarian because that was my first to 70, got my Paragon up to like 50, and then I use those just to help me get a little bit of a buff through the last of the, or the rest of the playthroughs.
I enjoyed that.
But now that I'm level like, I'll be level 200 Paragon, my monk should be fucking godly. How many rifts would it take to get to 70? If you played the story mode, you'll probably get to like 30, 35, and then it'd probably take you like, I'd say 20, 25 rifts, maybe, if that. Maybe I'd say closer to around 20. But that's assuming you did beat the story mode first, and you were able to start on hard.
Bad luck for you, friend.
Oh yeah, I'll for sure be able to do another rift. So I got 12% on this. This one's only taking about 10 minutes. So I should be like right on time. If I'm not, it's like 2 minutes late. You have a 43 second delay. Holy fucking shit, that is terrifying.
Not yet.
I enjoyed that.
Fuck out of my way! Heard boosting is OP on this game. Yeah, if you have a friend that's like Torment 5 or higher can carry your ass, yeah, it goes quick. Like, I keep telling my friend to get this game because I could literally get him level 70 in like 2 hours. But if you have a friend who's like torment like 13, you're gonna get fucking, you'll get level 70 in like a rip. In 722. Oh yeah, he can carry your ass then. You'll get level 70 in literally like 20 minutes.
You can only carry so much on the crusade.
Oh, my blood's filled. It's just blood. I'm not going to go back for it.
Excellent.
Fate smiles on you. What a steal.
That's too expensive.
Really? I used all of that and I didn't get dick? That's cool. Go fuck myself. Later, Gators. How many keystones do I have? 7? Alright, so I'll have 8 keystones I can transfer over to my barbarian. And then for the first, like, 2 hours tomorrow, I can do my barbarian, just Nephilim Rifts. And then just grind the fuck out of Greater Rifts for the last, like, 3 to 4 hours. And maybe I'll get a 200. If not, I'll probably just say fuck it, and then Friday, at like 11, I'll start the fucking monk, and then Saturday morning, finish the monk. Because honestly, I could finish the monk on Friday, but then I'm just giving it the little room. And if I finish the monk on Friday, then I'll play Killer Instinct Saturday morning for a couple hours. Because I don't work until 4 o'clock. So I will, I'll have a couple hours. I'll probably shoot from like 8 to like noon. Or 9 to noon or some shit. But it felt weird saying that you need to go back to work. It's always weird for me to say I have to go to work. I posted it on Facebook last night. I was like, wow, it's really weird to say I have work tomorrow.
Bad luck for you, friend.
Oh, wait, sorry. Should get out of my way. Buttholes. But today is just another training day. I'm gonna learn the ropes, figure out how the computer works there and shit. Or rather, how to navigate it and shit. So just normal. I would recommend normal. Yeah. At least I'm getting a couple legendaries right off the rip to cut some time off this bullshit. Yeah, but you would sound like a different person if you spelled right. There we go. Like for my monk, I'll probably start on hard, but that's only because I have like 200 paragon points to buff into it. And as I level up, the benefits from that will level up. Like when you're level 1, life regeneration per second, it'll only be like 0.02 per point, but it'll go up as you level up and get more health. So it levels up as you level up, basically. Well, I have fucking 50 points per category, so. Why do I want achievements so bad? I just grind achievements. It's just how I am. It bugs me that I don't have this fucking game completed right now. Yeah, my brother, when I was real little, like I was probably like nine to ten, I'd say. My brother would literally rent games. Fuck, this dates me. Blockbuster back in the day. Or he'd get them from Gamefly. And he would literally say, "Hey Josh, you wanna play Xbox?" And I'm like, "Yeah, sure." So I'm a fucking little kid, I just wanna play video games. He's like, "Here, play this game, go for the achievements, I have a guide for you." Like, alright, cool. I remember one game specifically I basically finished it for him. There's like a couple achievements that I didn't get yet. And that was Open Season. I literally almost maxed that game out in like 6 hours it took. Was not that bad. I was wee little. But that's probably where my passion started. Like, up and for a while, I didn't really, I didn't really, like, get into it until, like, probably a year into my Xbox 360 career. I would just play multiplayer games, and then I got games, and then I would fucking, I'd get new games, like, I want achievements. So I just started going for achievements. But that's just how I am. I watch a lot of achievement hunters like Stallion83, who has like 1.5 million gamer score. Actually, hold on, let me see what he's at right now. Oh, I'm surprised his ass isn't on. Where are you at, Stallion? Stallion83, he has 1,480,965 gamer score. Brown Man, which I think he just broke 700,000. A couple people I know have over 100K. But I want to have 100K gamer score probably by the end of this year. I want 90 by my birthday, but I don't see that happening. Channeling pylon. All right, later, Gator. It's like gamer score. It's not really. I mean, if you take into account the console's been out for Xbox has been around for 11 years now. So I mean, that averages to 8K a year. But I've only had this account for, this will be my fourth year. June 12th. It'll be 4 years. So it's 20,000 a year or so. But I remember when I got my Xbox One, I bought Ghosts and Rise Son of Rome. Both the games are fairly easy to get achievements in. Not terribly hard. I got like 2,500. Oh, the million? Yeah, that's a lot. Well, he makes a living off playing games for achievements. Like, he's got like 24 Xboxes that have been given to him for Microsoft. He has a lifetime, he's got lifetime gold to Xbox Live because of it. He streams, he uploads to YouTube. He's great. He's a very chill person. I've watched a couple of his streams. Like, he'll play games like right before they come out.
I enjoyed that.
Because he gets early access to them from Microsoft. So, but no, I still remember when I got my Xbox One, I got Rise and Ghost, and then I bought Spartan Assault. So I played Spartan Assault, got like 600 gamer score for that. Ghost got about 1,000 for that, and Rise got about 1,000 for that in like a week, or a weekend rather. I just sat down and grinded for hours on end for that weekend. Like, I think I played Xbox One for like fucking 40 hours out of 3 days. Like, my sister and brother-in-law got home from work because I was babysitting for them. I started playing at like 4. Started playing Rise. Got to the end of Rise by midnight that night. Started playing Ghost the next day. Beat Ghost. Started playing Extinction, beat Extinction, beat Spartan Ops. I just grinded So 40 hours out of like 72, I was literally just playing Xbox. I think I got like 3 hours of sleep each day. It was great. I loved it. But I think I got like fucking 3,000 gamer score in a week or a weekend. It was awesome. Now I think I have almost 70,000 gamer score on the Xbox One. Or no, I probably have like 60,000 on the Xbox One. I think I have like 20 to 25,000 on the 360. Damn it, why couldn't this be a channeling one? Almost done with this rift. I actually might be at almost 100,000 fucking kills for this game, to be honest. I'm gonna need to eat something before I fucking leave. I'm starving.
An incredible feat.
Oh, give me that. I love double damage. So useful, so useful. Why did it jump that fucking far away?
Cower before Zakharum.
The Rift Guardian has arrived.
Set piece. Fuck it. Oh wait, hold on. Ah, fuck it. Hit 156 though. One level higher than I wanted, than I was planning on. Alright, let's go get this power pylon. Can you get out of my way? My god, dude, this is fucking bugging me. There, now I can knock him down a lot faster. Later, Gator.
I'm returning to town.
I am returning to town. All right, let me speak to Auric, and then we'll get rid of all this shit.
Well.
Make sure nothing's better than what I have. Nope, garbage, 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 garbage. That's better. I'll take that. Nah, I'll do strength. Let's go salvage all this shit. I'll throw my keys in the bin just to be safe. Alright. Let me deposit my gems too. Alright. But that is going to do it for the stream today. I'll be back tomorrow for a lot longer of a stream. It won't only be fucking 3.5 hours. If you guys did enjoy and have not already, make sure you hit that follow button. I stream almost every day. And if you haven't already checked out my YouTube, I do have one. Same as my Twitch, Josh's new account. I upload every day. So if you ever miss a stream, since I do upload what I stream to YouTube, if you ever miss a stream, you can go there and check it out. And since I do upload everything I stream to YouTube, if you care to check out live stream, same as my YouTube, Josh's new account, twitch.tv/Josh's new account. Link should be in the description below, it usually is. But I hope you guys all have a wonderful day. I have to go do shit, unfortunately. Feels bad, man. Feels bad. But I will see you guys either tomorrow or in the next, or either the next live stream tomorrow or the next video. Take it easy, everyone.